Now, could fasting be the new antidepressant? I actually think so. There's minimal side effects. There's a lot of positive, amazing things that can happen in your body that go way beyond just losing weight and getting rid of your hunger. But in this video, we're going to talk about a study that I found that I'll put the link down below that's actually very, very fascinating. It involves improving your mood. So in this study, they found that the orexin signaling activity has increased. Now, what does orexin signaling activity mean? Orexin is a chemical in the body that will increase wakefulness, okay? So you'll feel more awake. If you're depressed, you're not very awake. So this is a very uplifting, higher mood sensation. Also, this will increase dopamine, which makes you feel better. Also, it's associated with happiness, because low levels of this chemical will cause sadness. And so many people, when they start doing a fast and they get past the first part where they have to convert into ketones, just start feeling really, really good. And they feel happier for sure. So number two, fasting can increase endorphin release. Endorphins give you the sensation of euphoria, which is a pleasure sensation, and also endorphins decrease pain. A lot of people get rid of their inflammation and pain when they do fasting. There's something about pain that actually makes you depressed as well. Next thing that it will increase, and I'm not gonna give you the chemical name, but it's CREB-TF. This compound signals certain genes that increase serotonin. It's been associated with people with a major depressive disorder. So when they test people with severe depression, they find this factor is low and fasting will increase it, okay? Next thing it increases is something called BDNF. This is brain-derived neurotrophic factor. Basically what that is, it's Miracle-Gro for your brain. It helps you grow new brain cells. So all these factors can be stimulated just by fasting. I mean, take a look at the flip side. The psych drugs are required to put a black label because there's some serious, serious side effects, not to mention covering up the real cause of the problem. And as you start taking an antidepressant, you need more and more of it because it doesn't work as well. And then you have to add another one. And before you know it, it doesn't work anymore. So why not try something that is so safe, that seems to be very, very effective, and it's natural. There's some other things you can do as well. Fish or cod liver oil filled with DHA and EPA is known to have an antidepressive effect. Vitamin D is known to reverse depression. Choline and whole eggs, and by the way, choline is in whole eggs, okay? Because this is involved in brain chemistry and there's a lot of great nutrients in whole eggs that can also improve your mood. Curcumin is a very powerful antioxidant that can also help. And also there's some research on a high fat diet that can help someone who's depressed. And if we take a look at the opposite effect on a low fat diet, that's when you actually increase the risk of depression and other cognitive problems. Thus the ketogenic diet, right? If you're new to my channel and you don't know how to do intermittent fasting, check out this video. I put it right here.